Introducing the world TV champion, accompanied to the ring by Madusa from Hollywood, California, at 258 pounds, stunning Steve Austin.
Austin, the television champion, at 258 from Hollywood. He knows he's in for the fight of his life, and fans will have it for you right after this timeout. And this match is for the television championship of the world. Ricky the Dragon Steamboat, the challenger, offering his hand in good sportsmanship. But it shouldn't be any surprise to Steamboat or any of the fans. Austin declined that gesture. Austin representing the Dangerous Alliance. It's been quite pleasant that Paul Lee has not been here in person the last couple of weeks. Certainly going to make my holiday better. And look at that. They know what's on the line here. And Steamboat, who has amassed a phenomenal record as a singles competitor. We talked about it last week. A former heavyweight champion of the world. Former United States heavyweight champion. I don't know if his focus is to become the television champion solely for that title, but perhaps more importantly, to damage the credibility and the bargaining power of the Dangerous Alliance with a victory here. Austin with the counter. He's 20 pounds larger than Steamboat, and that will be a factor. Have to wonder what's going through their minds as they gained eye contact. Two of the great, highly skilled athletes here in WCW. In this one fall, 15-minute time limit event. Austin now with the advantage, coming with the power moves, right hands, and with a 20-pound weight advantage, one would assume he would come with power in this contest. Steamboat, Suazo, and what a judo chop and a right hand. Steamboat now with an offensive flurry, has Austin in trouble. He knocks him out of bounds here, right out to the floor. Medusa, who has certainly changed her ring attire from earlier, looks quite nice, as a matter of fact. Double chop there by the Dragon. Steamboat building the momentum, and again, Austin knocked outside. We talked about last week the pending one-on-one matchup, a special challenge event involving Scott Steiner and stunning Steve Austin. We know that the Dragon and Dustin Rhodes will take on Anderson and Eaton very soon for the World Tag Team title. But Steamboat, with his experience, I feel will have the advantage to focus solely on Austin. Austin is only a couple of years in the sport. Will he have the ability to block out his pending matchup with Scott Steiner and focus solely on the Dragon? Steamboat picking it back up. Great pace. And Austin dropped down right in Steamboat's hands, literally. Want to remind the fans in the Atlanta area that tickets for the Omni event are on sale in advance at all Ticketmaster outlets. And if you wait until Christmas to buy your tickets, the Omni box office will open at 3 o'clock in the afternoon, Christmas Day. No, I plan on going home and spending Christmas with my family, but I will be on the first plane out of Oklahoma back to Atlanta. I will not miss Christmas night in the Omni. Steamboat holding on. Oftentimes you see an athlete shoved off from those particular maneuvers, especially when the opponent uses the ropes for leverage. Add a little momentum, but Steamboat held on very tenaciously. Again, the Dragon holds on. And Steamboat can, and Austin too for that matter, can really conduct the clinic. What's she doing there? Oh, she's trying to tell the referee that he was pulling the tights. I'm sure he was from the headlock position. That's not even remotely believable. Austin using his power to drive Steamboat into the turnbuckle. But look at the Dragon hold on to the headlock. And he will not let go. Well, it takes great concentration. He's trying to shake it loose there. But what a testimonial to the, not only the intensity of Steamboat, but his concentration to hold on to that very elementary of all wrestling maneuvers, the side headlock. And right there, fans, you've often seen wrestlers with cauliflower ears. That's one of the ways that they can be achieved, if that's a good word. Out of the back suplex, and Steamboat again holds on. But he's down in a pinning predicament. He's got to get that shoulder up, and he does. Steamboat perhaps crossing Austin up. He's not gone for the high-flying maneuvers that we have seen from the Dragon. He's gone with a ground attack here. And quite frankly, I think that it has caught Austin off balance. I'm sure that Austin thought that he would have to combat Steamboat's aerial maneuvers and his high-risk offense. But Steamboat has kept this match very, very basic, using the side headlock and now the front face lock. Steamboat, originally from Hawaii, now resides in beautiful Charlotte, North Carolina. Has a gymnasium there. Austin, perhaps the finest all-round athlete in World Championship Wrestling. I say that because he defends his title more than any other champion in this organization. And good move, and Steamboat again holds on. Austin pulling a page out of beautiful Bobby's playbook. Drops Steamboat again, and this time Steamboat is forced to relinquish the headlock. Two big-time backbreakers from Stunning Steve. And now we'll see if Austin focuses on the back. Front face lock, indeed he does, with that suplex. Three high-impact moves in succession from the television champion. And now he's on top with a lateral press. Steamboat able to kick out at two. Gut wrench, suplex, again. The point of attack, the lower back of Ricky Steamboat. Austin now, that kick to the mid-back area. And another one. Steamboat in, great elevation, what a backdrop. Steamboat quickly back up. And he'll quickly go back down. Well, sound game plan now by Austin. He's controlling the tempo. He slowed Steamboat down. And he's working on that back. And another backdrop. Backbreakers, kicks, and those backdrops. And Austin tells the ref to get down. On two. And a half. Oh, did he get it? No. He barely got the shoulder up. Steamboat just barely got the shoulder up before we had three. And last week, you were with us. Tremendous matchup involving Steamboat and beautiful Bobby. Steamboat got the pin, and then Austin came in, and between the two of them, they really tried to decimate Steamboat. And thank goodness Barry Windham was here. Uh-oh, he caught him. Waistlock inverted, atomic drop. And a clothesline. Steamboat up very quickly, to his credit. He will not stay down. He got to hand it to the Dragon. He's got tremendous heart. Great intestinal fortitude. But now Austin with a sleeper. No, it's not a sleeper. It's a reverse chin lock. He's still got that neck crimp in the beginnings of a sleeper. Now he goes into a more traditional sleeper hold as Medusa looks on from the outside. This is a big, big week in WCW. Some of the biggest wrestling cards of the year, involving the Dangerous Alliance in full force. As we said, the big one, the tradition in the Omni, Christmas night at 8 o'clock. 26th in Reunion Arena. 27th this Friday night in East Rutherford, New Jersey, in the Meadowlands, in the shadow of Giant Stadium. Good move by the Dragon. Also 1 week from today at 1 o'clock in Baltimore. And then, of course, in 8 days, perhaps the most unique and dynamic event of the pay-per-view history, Starrcade 91. Steamboat, with a great veteran move, not only distanced himself from Austin, but he drove Austin into the top ring rope. I know our fans, especially like our fans in Chattanooga, Tennessee, will be out in full force. Big event in Chattanooga on Monday, December 30th. Steamboat brought back in. No, he didn't. He was brought back in, but he gained the advantage in midair. What a resilient move by Steamboat, who's trying with all he has to get up. He has taken a tremendous amount of punishment, especially on his lower back. And even someone in as magnificent condition as Steamboat is having a hard time getting to his feet. Both men exchanging those right hands as they're both their game plans. Steamboat's ground attack and Austin's attack on the back have been basically thrown out the window here. It may be now the first man to create a break, and that may be it for the Dragon. Tremendous spinning kick by Ricky the Dragon Steamboat. And now the Dragon taking Austin to the turnbuckles. Steamboat reversed. Good leapfrog there by Austin. Oh, man, they collided, and it collided with a referee. The referee got hit right in the face. He falls out on his head. Steamboat and Austin ran together like two trucks. Steamboat may be dazed, but he's going up top. The referee is out of sight. Austin is up. Steamboat, the judo chop right off the top. He's got Austin pinned. There's another referee who counts him down. Wait a minute.
The winner of the match, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
I thought Austin foot made. That's what the referee is signaling. Mike Atkins was there and could see that. Austin's foot was under the bottom rope. A little chaotic here right now. And the referee's going to restart it. Austin throws him over the top rope. Now that's going to be a disqualification. Medusa out here. Oh. Well, Steamboat hit her. Steamboat, it's Austin from behind. Austin has lost the match via disqualification. Steamboat just, he wanted to strike Medusa, but he's too much of a gentleman. Austin retains the title via disqualification. What if there's beautiful Bobby? Eaton and Austin again, double teaming on the Dragon. They don't want to make him, let him make it to the Christmas Night Army event. Eaton and Austin trying to destroy the Dragon. And here comes Barry Windham. Windham, and they meet Windham coming in. Windham's right hand in the cast. They're taking over on Windham. Steamboat has been decimated. The referees have been laid out. Oh, it's chaotic here. Fans, we're running out of time. We'll see you tomorrow on the main event.